There's a dude. He had a theorem. You ready?
Yeah.
Yeah. Okay, let's do it. His theory goes like this. It involves right triangles. Right triangles is a triangle with a right angle in it, right? If this leg is known as A, it could be any value. This leg is known as B, it could be any value. And this is C. Does anyone know the other word for this? What's it called?
The hypotenuse.
Hypotenuse, that's right. This is the hypotenuse. The formula is whatever A squared is, you square it. Whatever B is, you square it. Whatever C is, you square it. And this formula will come to life. All right. Raise your hand if you've seen this before. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Many people. All right. Let's see if you've seen everything we're going to do. We're going to do 4 problems all together. The first one, you can predict what it's going to be. Here we go. Solve for the missing side. Oh, excuse me. Okay, what would you like to call this?
C.
C, good. Okay, formula. Yes?
So it becomes 8 squared, which is 64.
8 squared plus we'll get to 64 after.
Oh. Yeah.
Plus 15 squared.
15 squared.
Equals.
So I'm going to get this. I'm going to make this a little bigger. 8 squared plus 15 squared.
Equals C squared.
Equals C squared.
Yay.
Okay, yay. So you said this was 64?
Yes. I don't know what 15
plus 15 is. 225. 225, nice.
225.
And so it's 289.
289 is on the square root.
So, wait, what is this? 64 plus 225?
Yeah, 289.
289. Did you say that's going to take forever?
Yeah.
Despair not, my good student. What times what is 289? Guesses. I'm telling you it's a perfect square.
49.
Oh. It's too big.
36?
No.
24.
No, it can't be a 4. 4 times 4 ends in a 6.
17.
17. Good.
Just
7 times 7 is 49, so it ends in 9. That's a good trick. So it can't be 16, and it can't be 18, because those don't end in 9 when you square them.
17.
So take the square root of both sides, and C equals 17. Okay, good work. Watch what happens now. So here, we're gonna take this off. Okay, we're gonna take this. Okay. Are the following, yes, question.
I have a question. So yes. Then wouldn't it be the same as 8 plus 15 equals C?
Does 8 plus 15 equal 17?
Because if you square root them all like right there, then it would cancel.
It won't work. 8 plus 15 square root is not equal 17. Right? You have to square them each individually first. Okay? You guys are worth it. I'm going to get a strong marker. How does that sound?
Woo!
Yeah!
Yeah!
All
right, we got new markers.
Go
you like my
strong.
Tie? I believe in being formal.
Where did you get that tie, Miss?
Student.
I wonder.
Actually. Are the following sides making up a right triangle? Do these make up a right triangle? If we made a triangle with a piece of string 6 inches long, another string 8 inches long, another string 10 inches long, do these
yes.
make a right triangle?
Yeah.
Yes.
Let's prove it. How do you prove it?
Okay, so you want to make a right triangle and have 6 on one of the...
okay, so this is your theory, 6.
And then 8.
8.
And 10 is the hypotenuse.
But how do you know it's going to work? What if it's 89 degrees, not 90 degrees? How do you check if this is a right triangle?
If it's a perfect...
Protractor.
A squared.
Protractor is a good way to do it geometrically with measuring, but we can do it with this guy.
You just
just do it. It has to be a perfect square, doesn't it?
It has to, this equation, the Pythagorean theorem, it has to work. It has to check out. It has to work. So let's plug in. Which one will be our hypotenuse?
C, 10.
10. The hypotenuse is always the biggest side. Keep that in mind. Hypotenuse is always the biggest side. So we tried.
Isn't it always the right side?
Yes. It's the side opposite the right angle. And it's always the longest. So let's see if this works. 6 squared plus 8 squared equals 10 squared. And I put a little question mark here. If this is true, then it's a right triangle. Let's find out. 6 squared, yes.
36.
High five. 8 squared.
64.
Equals
100.
100.
It's, 64
is
36. 100.
100.
So it's a, it is
a right triangle.
Yes. If this equation did not work, if we got like 90 equals 100, then our answer would be no, it's not a right triangle. Okay, keep that in mind. Keep that in mind. Okay. You know what's really cool? I fast forward the erasing. Check this out.
Isn't this funny?
I don't get it.
When you fast forward, the voice goes like this. So I made my voice lower. You'll see what it means. Okay.
Okay.
Okay. Two mo.
It's like in cribs when they walk a long time, they fast forward the whole thing.
Yeah. Sometimes when I'm cleaning up, I wish I could fast forward it. You know, it looks really cool. Like,
that's how old TVs
folding, 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 close.
That's
I'm
how
kidding.
Old TVs work.
I know. What is the equation? You don't know? Okay, if you don't know, how do we start it? Maybe we could start with the formula.
Okay.
What's the formula?
A2 plus B2 plus C.
Good. Okay. So we can just say square.
Yeah, I know.
Right? I know you know it. So here we have three numbers. What's going to be A?
5.
5, sure. 5 squared. What's going to be B?
13 squared.
B squared.
All right, so this is the hypotenuse because it's like the slanted side. It's the side opposite the 90 degrees. And it will be the hypotenuse. It'll be over here. Questions about that?
Wait, what?
13 is the hypotenuse.
Yeah.
Bless you. And in our equation, that's C.
Oh, yeah.
So a big mistake that people make is they don't know where to put the 13.
So it's on the...
So it's over here. Do you agree that 13 is the hypotenuse?
Yes.
Do you agree that C is the hypotenuse within the equation?
Yes.
So we have to make 13C in this case. All right, and we'll mark this as B still.
Oh.
Yeah, you got it. You got
an idea? 5 squared is 25.
25.
You leave B squared, and then 13 squared is 169.
Bless you. 169, that's good. That's good. Good quick math there. All right, what do we do to both sides, yes?
And then you subtract 25.
Subtract 25.
And then it'll be B squared equals 144.
B squared is 144. Good. Square root both sides, yes?
12.
B equals 12. So that's our answer, 12. Here's a big, big pointer, a big hint for SAT. There are several what are called Pythagorean triples. Right? They're basically sides of a right triangle that always work. One of them is this, 5, 12, 13. You see these, you're like, oh, this makes a right triangle. 5, 12, 13 is a major one. The most major one, does anyone know it? It's called the 3, 4, 5.
What about 1, 2, 3?
1, 2, 3 won't work. Oh. Right? 1 squared is 1, 2 squared is 4. Right? So that's 1 plus 4 is 5. 3 squared is 9. So they're not the same. So 3, 4, 5 works. You can try it. 9 plus 16 equals 25.
Cool.
All right. Yeah, it is cool. Okay, one more. Oh, I'm back. I lost my consciousness.
There and back again.
Okay, here we go. Solve for C. I missed the joke.
No,
was it something funny?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I would laugh if it wasn't a joke.
Love the logic. It's great. Okay.
Hey, but...
Last one.
I get it.
Yes.
For the last one, don't we have to do the 12 to see if... Like, now that we know 12, don't we have to see if it's...
That would be a good way to check our work, would be to plug in 12 from what we did.
Yeah.
But we solved for 12 and we got it.
Okay.
It wasn't, do these three make a right triangle?
I think so.
It was, what is the third side of a right triangle?
Oh.
Two different questions. Yes.
I can't.
Yeah. Okay. We know formula. We have two sides. Who can set it up? Yeah? Would you like to try?
So it
loud.
Would be 4 squared.
4 squared plus...
11 squared, which would just be 11.
Very good. I'm going to write what you just said here. Equals?
C squared.
Yeah. Good. Very good.
So
okay, wait, I'm going to get more people involved, right? That's good. Next. What about here, here, here? Yes? I see hands. I love the hands. Yes?
So it's 16 plus 11 plus 11.
What is square root of 11 times square root of 11?
I don't know. Square root of 11, wait, what?
What
square
is
121?
Square root of 121?
11.
Which is 11.
I thought you said 11.
I know. I wanted to make sure you're sure. You're like, 11? And I'm like, 11. You see the difference?
Yeah, so much.
It is. It is. I want you to answer with an answer. All right?
11.
11. Good job. Good job. In other words, you can do it. You're okay.
Okay.
All right. Equals C squared.
Yeah.
What is? Yes?
27.
27. Then what do we do to both sides, sir? Both sides?
Wait, let's see. Oh, we need to square root it.
Yes, square root both sides.
So the square root of 27, isn't it 3 root 3?
The square root of 27 is 3 root 3, yes.
Oh.
3 root 3. We'll do it real quick. 9 times 3. Bless you, bless you. Let it rip. Square root of 9 is 3. Ooh, that's a funky 3. All right. 3 root 3 equals C. That was great, you guys. Questions? Yes?
Well, doesn't C always have to be the longest one?
It is. 4 is, okay, what's square root of 11? 3 point something?
Yeah.
Right? You understand it's 3 point
yeah.
something? 3 times square root of 3 is like 1.7.
Okay.
So 3 times 1.7 will be more than this 3 point something.
Okay.
It will be the longest side. All
right.
Will be the longest side. Good. Any other follow-up questions? Okay. What was our intro?
Yeah. 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 Yeah.